Sri Gurubhyo Namaha children, welcome to online class. Today's class we are going to learn about the ionization energy of transition and inner transition metal. Already you know that the ionization energy is the energy required to remove the loosely bound electron. So the variation of ionization energy, you might know that according to the periodic table it increases from left to right, that is from S block to P block. So the inner transition metals are lying in between S block and P block element. So while compare the ionization energy, the S block elements have less ionization energy and the P block elements have more ionization energy. So the steady increase in the ionization energy because of the electrons are enter into the same energy level. The same way here in the d orbital or the transition element also the same prediction of ionization energy. Now see this, in the transition elements are intermediate between the S and P block element. As we move from left to right, the transition series, the ionization energy is, or the ionization enthalpy is increasing as expected. What we learned that in general the ionization energy increases from left to right as we expected. This is due to that increase in the nuclear charge and the corresponding filling of the electron, because the new electrons added, the new electrons are added to the same energy level. Because of this reason the ionization energy is increasing. Now there is a variation, even though there is a steady increase in the ionization energy. So now scandium to chromium, you can see that there is a steady increase in ionization energy, but there is an abnormal. So if the steady increase means you should come like this only, but there is an abnormal variation in the increase in the ionization energy. Now you can see that the very steep increase of ionization energy of zinc. This is the comparison of 3D series from scandium to zinc. So from scandium to chromium there is a steady increase, and there is an abnormal because of the manganese. The manganese has 3D 5 electron, so that the off-filled, so what configuration? Off-filled configuration. So this going to show the extra stability. Due to that off-filled configuration, due to the extra stability of the ion present in 3D orbital, so the ionization energy is high, more, because we cannot able to remove the ionization energy easily. And after that, like that, in ion 3d6, so what is increasing? The unpaired electrons, the paired electrons are increasing, so or the number of d electrons are increasing, so that it shield the 4s electron. It reduce, so that what is increasing? The ionization energy. So it decreasing the attraction, it decrease the attraction towards the nucleus and the orbital, so that ionization energy is increasing. And then the same way here, 3d 10 4s 1, so completely filled d orbital, so the first time, while comparing with first ionization energy and the second ionization energy, the second ionization energy is greater when compared to first one. And then in zinc the configuration is 3d 10 4s 2, completely filled, completely filled orbital. It shows the extra stability. So it need more, greater ionization, so that there is a steady increase in the ionization energy. So this is the comparison This is the comparison of 3D series in the transition metal. And next, why there is an increase in the first ionization energy enthalpy with increase in the atomic number is not regular. What we learn that in this case, while first ionization enthalpy is increasing with increasing atomic number is not regular. Now you see this. This is not regular. Why? Because it is not regular. Because the added electrons. Because the added electrons are enter into n minus 1 d orbital, and the inner electrons are acting as a shielding effect, decrease the nuclear charge. Nuclear charge of the ns. What I said, this is 3d electron and this one is 4s electron, increasing the number of d electron. So there is a repulsive force between one, the 3d and 4s. By this it reduces the shielding, or it increases the shielding effect and reduces the nuclear charge of ns electron, and therefore this leads to the variation in the ionization energy. So that there is a variation in the ionization energy among the series, and the ionization energy value also can be used for prediction of the thermodynamic stability. So based on the ionization energy, the thermodynamic stability also depends upon this ionization. Now we see this while comparing the two element nickel and platinum. The first nickel 2 plus and platinum 2 plus, by removing first electron from nickel it requires 737 kilojoules, and then it requires second electron. So the nickel need 2490 kilojoules per mole, and then for platinum, removal of the first electron is called what? Ionization energy. Why it is greater, the second ionization, why IE2 is greater? Because we are going to remove the net positive charge ion. We are going to remove the electron from the net positive charge ion. But here we are in the first IE. In IE1 we are going to remove the electron from neutral atom. In this case the number of protons and neutrons are equal. So that the variation among the first ionization energy and the second ionization, while compare, the greater the second, because we are going to remove from the net positive charge. We are going to remove the net positive charge from the ion. So we are going to remove the electron from the net positive charge, so that the second. So while compare the ionization energy, first ionization energy, ionization energy of nickel and platinum, which one requires very less? The nickel required less than the platinum 2 plus. So that while compare this thermodynamic stability, the nickel 2 plus ion is more stable than what? Platinum 2 plus ion, because it requires more energy. Based on the ionization enthalpy, the thermal stability also assigned based on ionization energy. So these are all about the one of the property of transition metal. And next, one more property is the magnetic property. So almost the transition metals are, most of the metals elements are magnetic in nature. So now if the most of the compounds in the transition metals are paramagnetic, magnetic paramagnetic means what? They are attracted towards the magnetic field, and the magnetic property also related on the electronic configuration. Electronic configuration become based on the number of unpaired electrons. Number of unpaired electron. So the electron spinning. So in the electrons in the d orbitals. Suppose for manganese 3d5. So they are going to spin on their own axis. The unpaired electrons are spinning on their own axis as well as the orbital moment. Orbital moment means what? They are moving. They are moving within the orbital as well as the electrons is going to spin on their own axis. By this spinning, due to this spinning around the nucleus, the magnetic field is going to be generated. The magnetic field is going to generate in terms of magnetic momentum. Understand how the magnetic field is going to be generated? The electron present in the orbitals, they spin on their own axis as well as they are spinning within the orbitals around the nucleus. So that these motions are create a tiny magnetic field. So this tiny magnetic field is called what? The magnetic momentum. So now on the basis of this magnetic momentum, we are going to classify the elements as paramagnetic material and diamagnetic material, and then ferromagnetic as well as antiferromagnetic. Based on the magnetic momentum, how the magnetic momentum is creating by spinning, or the motion between what? The spinning of the electron on their own axis as well as spinning around the orbital, around the nucleus. This motions create a magnetic field. This is called what? Magnetic momentum. Based on this, we are going to classify the elements as paramagnetic, diamagnetic, ferromagnetic as well as antiferromagnetic. And now what is meant by diamagnetic? Now we are going to learn about what is meant by diamagnetic. So all the materials all have the elementary magnetic dipoles. All the elements are, and if the element doesn't have elementary magnetic dipoles, so most of the elements have what? Magnetic dipoles due to the motion between the electrons on their own axis as well as around the nucleus. So if the element doesn't have no elementary magnetic dipole, they are called as what? Diamagnetic. They are called as what? Diamagnetic. The diamagnetic means what? They are not attracted towards the external magnetic field. Now you see that why they are not attracted by the external magnetic field, because one of the cases the material should all the electrons are paired, or absence of unpaired electron. So why they are diamagnetic in nature? Because of the paired electron exhibit the diamagnetism. If the elements contain all the paired electron, so they cannot attract by the external magnetic field. And next, one more thing is the repulsion. The materials are repelled by the magnetic field, because within the material itself, what is going to form? A magnetic induction. That magnetic induction produces a magnetic field. Because of this magnetic field within the material, the presence of what? External. There is a repulsion between. There is a repulsion. Here, see that. There is a repulsion between the magnetic field, internal magnetic field. How this internal magnetic field is formed by the magnetic induction due to the motion of the electron within the material. So this repulsion between the magnetic field and the external magnetic, so that they are all repelled by the external field. So the magnetic induction is introduced to the material, which generate the weak magnetic field. This induction, magnetic induction, is formed due to the movement of the electron. So that makes the magnetic field is weak. So it opposes the applied magnetic field. The applied magnetic field is nothing but what? The external magnetic field. So that the diamagnetic materials or the diamagnetic substances are repelled by the external magnetic field. And next, paramagnetic. So what is meant by paramagnetic? Paramagnetics are attracted towards the magnetic external magnetic field. Why? Because the paramagnetic materials all have unpaired electrons, and the diamagnetic, what we learn, that is all the paired electrons. Due to the paired electron, they are repelled by the external magnetic field, and here due to the presence of unpaired electron, they possess what? The magnetic dipole. The magnetic dipole, that magnetic dipole makes the isolate the electron. The magnetic dipole created due to the presence of unpaired electron, they make isolate. They are going to separate each other. So the absence of the external field, these dipoles are exist as a random. They are going to exist as random. The random, and there is no net magnetic property. So the dipoles are present as a randomness. And if we apply, or if the material should be in the presence of the magnetic field, they are going to align. They are going to align what? They are going to align parallel to the direction of, or parallel to the direction of the magnetic field. They are going to align. So before that, they are random, the magnetic field, so that they cannot able to show the net magnetism in the form of material. Understand? Then if we applied in the external magnetic field, then it apply the external magnetic field, these dipoles are arranged. These dipoles are arranged towards the direction of the external magnetic field. In this way, it attract the external magnetic field, so that they are attracted by the external magnetic field. So this is one based on the electron. If the material have unpaired electrons, they are attracted towards the external magnetic field. If the material does not have the unpaired electrons, they are not attracted by the magnetic field. And one more classification based on the magnetic property is ferromagnetic material. The ferromagnetic materials have domain structure. In each domain, the magnetic dipoles are arranged, and they spin the dipoles, they adjust the domain randomly. So now you see the domain, this is one of the domain and this one is another domain. So in each domain, they have, the direction is going to be different. So what is this? The magnetic material domain structure, each domain magnetic dipoles are arranged and they all have different direction. Each domain have different direction. After that, if we apply the electric external magnetic field, if apply the external magnetic field, these domains are arranged towards the direction of the magnetic field. See, this is in this way they are going to be attracted by the external magnetic field. So now all the domains, they are arranged towards the magnetic field, external magnetic field. So by in this due to this arrangement due to this arrangement inside the domain, so that they are attracted towards the magnetic field. So that some of the transition elements are ion with unpaired electron can show what? Ferromagnetism. And next, how to measure the magnetic field, so or the magnetic momentum. So the 3D transition metals are paramagnetic and corresponding to the electron spin. So how we are going to calculate the magnetic property based on what? Magnetic momentum. How we are going to calculate? Mu equal to G into root of S into S plus 1 mu B. So here G, what is G equal to 2, it is a constant, and S is spin quantum number. Spin quantum number, and mu B is Bohr magneton. Bohr magneton. So now for n electron, for ions, n number of electron, the S is going to be, S is equal to n by 2. S is equal to n by 2. Now you substitute this mu equal to, what is G? G is equal to 2. So 2 into root of n by 2 into n by 2 plus 1 Bohr magneton. So if you take LCM, 4 into 2 into 2 plus 1. So this 4 and root 4 get cancelled. So mu equal to root of 2 into 2 plus 1. The unit is Bohr magneton. So this is the formula to find the magnetic momentum. Now you can see this magnetic momentum for the 3D series. Some of the element, the scandium 3 plus, the scandium ions 3 plus, it has what? 0. There is no electron, unpaired electron. So unpaired electron, the S value is become 0. So n equal to 0. So the what is this? The observed value as well as experiment value becomes 0. So it is paramagnetic, or it is a diamagnetic. And 1, n equal to 1 means root of n into n plus 1. By based on this we can calculate the magnetic momentum. The same way for zinc and gallium are completely filled d orbital, and the number of unpaired electron is 0, so that they are what? They are diamagnetic in nature. By the value you can see the magnetic. So the spin, the by applying this formula we can able to find the magnetic momentum of the material, either it is a paramagnetic or a diamagnetic. So these are all about the properties of transition metal. One of the property is ionization energy and magnetic property. And the next video we will see about the standard electrode potential of transition metal. Thank you for watching this video, children. To receive our online lesson, please press subscribe button to receive the latest update. Thank you.